has overcome. We will not be shaken. We will not be moved. Jesus, you are here. I will not die. The resurrection power of Christ alive in me, and I am free in Jesus' name. Carrying our burdens, covering our shame, He has overcome. Yes, He has overcome. We will aside for the joy of a Christ. Let your glory fall. Our hearts are filled with your fire. No other past your love. The things of now or to come. There's nothing on earth in this life that could ever separate. Your love is never ending. To your hands we surrender. Where all our sins are washed away. Your grace be our reason. Has paid for our freedom. We're made alive in you. We run to your throne. Where we belong. Every heart will sing that Jesus is Lord, casting all else aside for the joy of a Christ. Let your glory fall, our hearts are filled with your fire. Your love is never ending. To your hands we surrender. Where all our sins are washed away. Your grace beyond reason has paid for our freedom. We're made alive in you. We run to your throne. Where we belong. Every heart will sing that Jesus is Lord, casting all us aside for the joy of a Christ. Let your glory fall. Our hearts are filled with your fire. We run to your throne where we belong. Every heart will sing that Jesus is Lord, casting all us aside for the joy of a Christ. Let your glory. Our hearts are filled with your fire. Filled with your fire. Filled with your fire. Filled with your fire.
Hello, good morning. Magandang umaga po sa bawat sa po sa atin. Balikbahay po tayo ngayon pong umaga at kahit sa ang lugar po tayo naroon, kahit sa ang dako po tayo naroon, nandun po ang ating Panginoon. Sinabi po ng Bible na kung merong dalawa o tatlo na nagtitipon po sa kanya pong pangalan, ay naroon po ang presensya ng ating pong Panginoon. Kaya wala pong problema kung sa ang dako po tayo sumasamba po ngayon ay talagang we can worship God anywhere, everywhere. Because the Bible says, we can worship God in spirit and in truth. So wherever you are right now, we encourage you to just worship God in spirit and in truth, together with your family. And may I suggest, you invite friends. Kay imbitahan nyo po ang inyong mga kapitbahay, dalin nyo po sa inyong mga tahanan, at sama-sama po kayong manood, sumamba sa ating pong Panginoong Diyos. In the meantime, tayo pong lahat ay yumuko, tayo po'y pumikit, tayo po'y manalangin. And let's worship God in prayer today. Let's pray. Our dear God, our most heavenly Father, today we are so blessed, Lord. We are so blessed because wherever we are, worship is still worship. Kung meron pong dalawa o tatlo na nagtitipon po sa inyong pangalan, naroon po kayo sa amin pong kalagitnaan, Panginoon. Dahil ang pagsamba is no boundaries, Lord. So, Lord, thank you because regardless of our very situation, Lord, still we can worship you. Thank you, Father, for the privilege of worshiping you in spirit and in truth. Thank you, Father, for the privilege and the opportunity that we could come before your presence anytime, anywhere. Kaya nga po, Panginoon, it's not about circumstances. It's not about situations. It's all about our hearts. Kaya nga po, Panginoon, aming pong ikinukumit sa inyo ang aming mga puso po ngayon na linisin po ninyo, itama po ninyo yung mga maling desires namin, mga maling motives namin, Panginoon, inyo po itong itama. Dalin niyo po kami, i-align niyo po, Panginoon, ng aming pong puso sa isang tunay na pagsamba po ngayon pong umaga. Panginoon, ngayon pong umaga, alam niyo po kung ano po ang mga laman ng aming pong mga puso. Meron po sa amin dito ay meron po siyang mga dinadalang mga kabigatan. Maaring siya ay nalulungkot. Maaring siya ay natatakot. Maaring siya ay nape-pressure. Maaring siya po, Panginoon, ay nag-aalala. Maaring siya po ay nababalisa. Maaring iba ay nagagalit. Maaring ang iba po ay meron siyang daladalang kawalan ng pagpapatawad, unforgiveness sa kanya pong puso. Panginoon, kung ano man po yung mga laman po ng aming mga puso po ngayon, amin po itong ipinagtatagubilin po sa inyo. Ituwid niyo po ang aming mga puso, bigyan niyo kami ng isang pusong mapagsamba. At amin po, Panginoon, ngayong umaga, na iniaalay ang amin pong mga sarili bilang mga haing buhay, banal at katanggap-tanggap po sa inyo. At akin pong dalangin, Panginoon, na tanggapin ninyo ang aming pong humble worship, Lord. Receive our humble worship today, Lord. Father God in heaven, today we want to know you deeper in our lives. Sapagkat mentras namin kayong nakikilala ng malalim sa aming buhay, lalo namin kayong mamahalin at dahil na mahal namin kayo, kayo po'y aming susundin at the more we obey you, Father God, the more you will bless us. You will bless us in many ways. And that is our prayer for each and every family today, that you would bless every family, whatever their situations, Father, bless them, not only with material things, not only with on financial aspects, but also with spiritual blessings, Lord, that they will get to know you deeper in their lives, Lord. Protect us in every sickness, Lord. Protect us from harm. And most especially, Father, may you protect us from the evil ones. Today, as I share your words, O Lord, may you help me. May you teach me what to say, Lord, today, and what not to say. May you fill me with your Holy Spirit, Lord. Lord, apart from the Holy Spirit, I admit to you, Lord, that I can really do nothing. And that is why I need the empowering and the infilling of the Holy Spirit, Lord, especially the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Father God in heaven, bless your words today. Speak to your people personally and in a very personal and special way. For this we all pray in the name of your one and only true Son, Jesus Christ. All the people said, amen and amen. Magandang umaga po muli sa bawat sa po sa atin. At ako po'y excited dito po sa ating pong series, sa pagpapatuloy po ng ating series na kung tawagin ay Five Smooth Stones, The Story of David and Goliath. Alright? But before we go to our very message for today, I just wanna remind everyone that here in Acts 2 Community Church, ay meron po tayong accountability group. At hinihilingan ko po at ini-encourage ko po ang bawat isa na kayo po ay mag-join sa ating pong A group. Ang ating pong A group ay isang maliit na grupo na kung saan ay tayo po ay nagpapanalanginan, tayo po ay encourage to one another, tayo po ay nagdadalahan ng mga kabigatan sa isa't isa, At lahat po ng mga one another's na yan na nakalagay po sa Biblia ay ating pong ginagawa in a very small group setup. That is what we call accountability group. So, akin po kayong ini-encourage na mag-iwan po kayo ng mga ng mensahe diyan sa inyong comment box at i-join po namin kayo sa accountability group. Kung dahil po tayo ngayon ay baliktahanan po tayo, balikbahay po tayo, tayo po ay nag-o-open ngayon ng Zoom A group. Alright? Or video call A group, kung anumang kapamaraanan na pwede natin gawin basta hindi po maputol ang ating pong relationship as brothers and sisters in the Lord so that we could still live a healthy Christian life, healthy, normal Christian life, yan po ay ginagawa po natin ng paraan. Alright? So, kahit po ganito ang ating pong sitwasyon, tuloy pa rin po ang ating pong accountability group. Hindi man po ito face-to-face, ay meron po tayong Zoom A group or video call A group. Alright? So, join an accountability group and we will be glad to really join you. Mag-iwan lamang po kayo ng mga komento dyan na nagpapahayag na gusto po ninyong mag-join ng ating pong small group o ng ating accountability group. Pangalawa po ay kung na-miss po ninyo ang ating pong mga mensahe, na-miss po ninyo ang ating pong mga previous series, ay salamat po sa Diyos. Binigyan po tayo ng isang technology na kung saan pwede po nating mapanood pa yung mga nakalipas po nating mensahe na na-miss po natin. No? Tayo po dito sa Acts 2 Community Church ay nagbuo po ng production team or live production team na kung saan sila po ay dinidevelop po nila ang ating pong social media platform. At tayo po ngayon ay nasa YouTube channel. Puntahan nyo lamang po yan, mag-subscribe lamang po kayo sa ating pong YouTube channel at i-search nyo lamang po yung ating church, yung Acts 2 Community Church at makikita po ninyo lahat ng mga mensahe na hindi po ninyo napanood at hindi po ninyo nasubaybayan, ina-upload po yan ng ating pong team. No? So, puntahan nyo po yan at i-encourage nyo po yung mga kaibigan po ninyo, i-share nyo po yung mga videos na yan so that they as well could subscribe and enjoy those messages and they will get to know God as their Lord and personal Savior and they will become followers of Jesus. That is the very reason why we are continually and continuously developing our social media platform so that we could reach the four corners of the globe through the words of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen? So, what are you waiting for? Just subscribe and enjoy all those messages that you have missed. Alright? At last but not the least is this, very important, bahagi po ng ating pong pagsamba ay yung ating pong tithes and offering. Dahil po tayo ay hindi po ngayon nakikita-kita, meron po tayo din namang ginawang kapamaraanan upang inyo pong mga tithes and offering ay inyo pong maibigay kahit nandyan lamang po kayo sa inyong mga tahanan. Pwede po kayong mag-transfer ng funds sa account number na nakikita po ninyo ngayon sa inyong screen. At we will be glad to for you. We will be glad na kayo po ay maging bahagi ng ating pong tithes and offering so that God will bless us not only materially, financially, but in every aspect of our lives. Alright? So, that is part of our worship, our tithes and offering. At just give transfer funds, tithes and offering, love gift, or you want to donate. At yan po, ginagamit po natin para po ang ating pong gawain, ang ating pong ministeryo dito po sa Acts 2 Community Church ay magpatuloy with your financial support. Amen? And for those of you who are faithfully giving your tithes and offering, may God bless you real good. Amen? May God bless you real good. So, Tuloy na po tayo sa ating pong mensahe po ngayon. Ano po ang mensahe po natin ngayon? Okay? Ang mensahe po natin, last Sunday, bago po ako tumuloy sa ating pong exciting topic po ngayon, eh yung mensahe po natin last Sunday, very, very encouraging and very inspiring message. Ano nga po yun? Ang mensahe po natin last Sunday ay pinamagatan po natin, the warrior is a child. Meaning to say, we are children of God, and because we are children of God, the Bible says we are warriors. Sabihin mo nga dyan sa kasambahay mo o sa kasama mo sa bahay, kapamilya mo, we are warriors. Ayan, we are warriors. Tayo ay warriors. At actually, hindi lang po talaga tayo warriors. Sinabi nga po ng Bible sa Romans 8, verse number 37, that we are more than warriors. We are more than conquerors. Amen? Yun po yung pinag-usapan natin last Sunday, na tayo po ay higit pa sa mapagtagumpay. At dahil tayo ay mga anak ng Diyos, tayo po ay mapagtagumpay, eh, kayang-kaya po nating mapagtagumpayan ang mga tukso sa ating pong buhay. Kaya po nating mapagtagumpayan ang kasalanan sa buhay natin. Kaya po nating mapagtagumpayan ang trials sa buhay natin. Why? Because we are warriors. Alright? Because we are warriors. And, ano po sabi po natin nung last Sunday? Because we are warriors, our identity is God Himself. Ang identity natin ay hindi po yung kung ano yung meron tayo at kung ano yung wala tayo. Hindi, ang identity po natin ay ang Diyos mismo. Remember David? David, sinusubukan po ni King Saul na ipasuot sa kanya yung kanyang bronze helmet at yung kanya pong armor. Hindi po isinuot ni David. Well, tinray po ni David. No? Tinray po ni David na isuot po yon, tinitignan niya kung kaya niya rin isuot. Pero sabi ni David kay King Saul, no? Well, sorry sir, I have not tested it. No? Hindi ko pa ito nasusubok eh. Ang ibig sabihin lamang po ni David, this is not my identity. So, David rather chose to what? Pick up 5 smooth stones as his weapons to kill and defeat Goliath. And also his rod, his stick that he uses to tend sheep. Meaning to say, sinasabi dito ni King David na, o ni David, ni shepherd boy, sinasabi ni David, hindi yan ang identity ko eh. Huwag mo akong piliting maging King Saul Jr. I am David the shepherd boy and God called me to be a shepherd boy and this is my identity and my identity is God. Well, I like your suggestion na ibigay mo sa akin yung armor at ang iyong bronze helmet. Pero sabi ni David, sorry sir, that is not my identity. I can kill Goliath by my stick and by these 5 smooth stones because my identity is God Himself. So just like us, our identity is God. So do not be so, wag tayong masyadong, do not so be bothered, no? Kung ano yung wala ka at kung ano yung meron ka kasi hindi naman yan ang identity mo. Ang identity mo as a warrior, as a conqueror, eh yung Diyos mismo, yung Father mo, yung ating God na lumikha ng langit at ang lupa. He is your very much identity. That's why you have nothing to worry about your identity. Okay? So, number two, dahil tayo ay warriors, we are more than conquerors, we are children of God, not only God is our identity, but God is our security. Alright? Our God is our security. So, just like David, no? Just like David, kontento na siya na ang kanyang sandata ay 5 makikinis na bato at isang yung tungkod na ginagamit niya sa kanyang pagpapastol dahil naniniwala siya, yun yung sandata na ibinigay sa kanya ng Diyos at it's not about the weapons. It's all about God is with me. Sabi niya, the Lord who delivered me from the paw of the lion and from the paw of the bear, He will deliver me from the hand of this giant, this Philistine Goliath. What do you see with David? David was very much secure. Not only with himself, not only with his weapons, but with God himself. He believes with all his heart that God puts him there. God assigned him to kill that 9-footer giant by the name of Goliath. No insecurities, no shadows of insecurities that you can see in the face of David. And so, he fought against Goliath. He killed Goliath. Why? Because his security and his identity is God himself. And also, because we are warriors, we have talked about last Sunday that God is our victory. Ang tagumpay natin ay walang iba kung hindi ang ating pong Diyos mismo. Alright? So, when David, struck Goliath, Goliath fell down, he fell his face to the ground. Alright? So, David, after that incident, after he struck Goliath, what did David do? Tumakbo siya ng mabilis talaga. Sinigurado niya, tumakbo siya ng mabilis. Kinuha niya yung espada ni Goliath at kanyang itinarak. At hindi lang po yan, kanya pong pinugutan ng ulo si Goliath at kanyang ibinalandra sa people of Israel at sa mga Pilisteo yung ulo ni Goliath. It was a victorious event, not only for David, not only for the people of Israel, but for God himself. God is our victory. At the end of the day, it was the name of the Lord who was proclaimed when David defeated Goliath, killed Goliath through that smooth stone and through the sword of his very own enemy. What is our application to that? Our application to that is this. Our application at the end of the day, God is our victory. You may feel like you are a failure. You may feel like you are bankrupt today. No, sir, no, ma'am. If you have done your best, if you have given your best shot for the calling that God has given you, for the purpose, you have fulfilled your purpose in life, nothing to be insecure, nothing to be afraid of, nothing to worry about, nothing to be ashamed of, because your victory is God Himself. In God's eyes, you are victorious. Bago po puntahan yung mensahe po natin ngayon, sabihin mo nga sa katabi mo ngayon, matagumpay ka na. Amen? You are victorious. So what's our message for today? Our message for today is this. Ang mensahe po natin ngayon, ipagpatuloy po natin. Mga kaibigan, what happened when David killed Goliath? Well, everybody was rejoicing. Everybody was, was celebrating. It was a victorious day for the people of Israel. You know what happened? When David killed Goliath, the Philistines, they fled. Nagsitakbuhan po sila. You know what the people of Israel did? Hinabol po nila ang mga Pilisteo at ginawa po nila itong captives, kanila pong pinlander, yung kanila pong mga camps, etc., etc. I mean, in short, it was a victorious day. And for David, it's game over. For David, it's game over. Alright? Tingnan po natin sa 1 Samuel chapter number 17, the very last part of chapter number 17 when David killed Goliath. Then David took the Philistine's head and brought it to Jerusalem, but he put his weapons in his tent. Now when Saul saw David going out against the Philistine, he said to Abner, the commander of the army, "Abner, whose son is this young man?" Well, King Saul was so impressed with what David did. He was so impressed. So what he did, he called his commander by the name of Abner, and this is his query, "Whose son is this young man, Abner?" And Abner said, "By your life, O king, I do not know." Let's go. The king said, "You inquire whose son the youth is." So, was King Saul so impressed with what David said, with what David did? Very obvious. King Saul was so impressed na impressed siya sa ginawa po ni David, the young boy na sa tingin ni King Saul, nung kausap niya, nung ini-interview niya, "You are not qualified. You are not able." Pero yung isang bata na kanyang minaliit at sinabihan ng hindi kaya, yun ang pumatay sa napakalaking higante na kinatatakutan mismo ni King Saul. So King Saul was so impressed with that victory of David. Again, not only for the people of Israel, but for the God of Israel, the Lord of hosts, the God of the armies of Israel, by the name of Yahweh, Jehovah. But wait, there's more. For King David, for David, it was game over. But not so with King Saul. At the very first, si King Saul, siya ay impressed na impressed. But ladies and gentlemen, let us see what happened next. Alright? Let us see what happened next. Let's go. Let's go to verse number 6 of chapter 18. "It happened as they were coming, when David returned from killing the Philistine," meaning Goliath, "that the women came out of all the cities of Israel, singing and dancing to meet King Saul with tambourines, with joy, and with musical instruments. The women sang as they played and said, 'Saul has slain his thousands, but David his 10,000s. You know what was the reaction of King Saul to that jubilation? Verse number 8, let's see. "Then Saul became very angry, for this saying displeased him, and he said, 'They have ascribed to David 10,000s, but to me they have ascribed thousands. Now what more can he have but the kingdom?' So look at David with suspicion from that day on." Wait a minute. There is a big problem here. Nung una, impressed na impressed siya kay David sa ginawa ni David. Pero nung kumanta na yung mga babae ng Israel, na pinupuri si David because, you know, David, as these women of Israel, composed a song and they sang a song, you know, dinig na dinig ni King Saul yung papuri para kay David. Oh, well, may lyrics po yan actually. May nota po yan. No, may nota. Kanta po yun eh. Kumanta po sila ni isang awit yung sinasabi na, "Well, Saul killed thousands, but David killed 10,000s. Meaning to say, you know, puring-puri ng people of Israel si David. You know what happened to King Saul? The Bible says, King Saul was very angry. And that is our topic for today. For King Saul, for David, it's game over. But for King Saul, it ain't over yet. In Tagalog, hindi pa tapos ang laban. There is another giant that King Saul had to conquer. What is that giant? That is the giant of anger. Everybody say anger. That is a much taller giant for King Saul. Are you with me so far? Anger is a much taller giant than Goliath himself. And Saul had to conquer his very own giant called anger. And the message for today is entitled, "Conquer Your Anger." Sabihin mo nga sa katabi mo, "Conquer Your Anger." conquer your anger. Gapiin mo ang galit mo. Whether we like it or not, or believe it or not, ladies and gentlemen, many people today are angry. Are you angry today? Because of what's happening in the world, many people today are angry. Amen? Companies are angry at the government. Employees are angry at their own companies. Husbands are angry at their children. And everything. Ang question ko po ngayon pong umaga, ganito. Ikaw ba ngayon ay galit? Tingnan mo nga yung katabi mo. Kung galit siya. Kung galit siya. Mga kaibigan, anger is a giant in our lives. Anger is something that we have to conquer, whether we like it or not. Because, listen to this, if we do not conquer our anger, the negative emotion of anger, sooner or later, this giant of anger will conquer us. I repeat, if we do not act on this negative emotion of anger, this giant of anger, ladies and gentlemen, sooner or later, anger will be the one to kill you. Because anger is a very dangerous negative emotion. Are you with me? It might kill your company. It might kill your family. It might kill your future if you are not careful and if you are not aware of it. Again, in the case of King Saul, when King Saul saw how the women of Israel celebrated for King David, they really applaud David for what he did to that 9-footer giant by the name of Goliath. They really celebrated, and King Saul, instead of rejoicing with these women, he got very angry, the Bible says. And that's what we're gonna conquer today. The giant of anger. King Saul's anger is just like an iceberg. King Saul's anger is just like an iceberg. Have you seen an iceberg? Well, again, many of us have not seen an iceberg. But as you see in the picture, King Saul's anger is just the tip of an iceberg. Underneath are negative emotions na nagpagalit kay King Saul. And that's what we're gonna see. What are underneath that iceberg, negative emotions, na nagbigay ng napakalaking galit at matinding galit, should I say, kay King Saul. Number one, you know, the Bible says, King Saul was envious against David. Let's see the verse. When King Saul saw that the women of Israel ascribed to David 10,000s, and they were rejoicing, what happened? Sabi ni King Saul, but to me, they have ascribed thousands. Now, what more can he have but the kingdom? But I would like to give emphasis to that phrase, but to me, they have ascribed thousands. What is that? Ladies and gentlemen, that is what we call envy. Envy, kung bakit tayo nagagalit, kung bakit tayo galit na galit, it might be that you are envious. Maaring inggit ang pinanggagalingan ng galit ng tao, mga kaibigan. Number one, yung tinatawag nating inggit or your envy. Ikaw ba ay maiinggitin? Yes or no? Well, many people today, when they open their social media, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and even YouTube, and they see their colleagues or maybe their friends or maybe their former classmates or maybe their former relatives, they are ahead of them. And they see, oh, my classmate, 10 years ago, he was not like that or she was not like that. But now, he and she is ahead of me financially. At mukhang mas maganda siya sa akin ngayon. So what happens to us? We get envious. At dahil tayo ay naiinggit alo nangyari sa atin, it affects our emotions. So what happens? Gagalit tayo. Nagagalit tayo kahit yung mga pusa sa bahay natin, pinagagalitan natin, nasisipan natin, kahit yung mga alaga nating aso, napapagalitan natin. Bakit? Ang pinanggalingan pala niyan, pagbukas mo ng social media account mo, eh, inggit na inggit ka sa kapitbahay mo, inggit na inggit ka dun sa classmate mo, inggit na inggit ka dun sa kung sino man yan na kinainggitan mo. Ladies and gentlemen, in the case of King Saul, he was so envious at David when the women of Israel applauded and celebrated for David. Envy. Number two, root cause of King Saul's anger is not only envy. Underneath that iceberg is what? Insecurity. Insecurity is one of the major reasons why King Saul was so angry at David. Look at the verse. You know, look at the verse when the women of Israel. So, let's go to that verse again and let us see. Verse number 8 again. Then Saul became very angry. Why? For this saying, this displeased him. You know, that displeased King Saul. Why? And he said, they have ascribed to David 10,000. But to me, they have ascribed thousands. Now, this is the point. Now, what more can he have but the kingdom? That is insecurity. In King Saul's mind, kukunin ni David ang kaharian eh. Dahil siya ay talagang pinuri ng husto ng people of Israel, the whole kingdom, nai-insecure dito si King Saul. Nai-insecure si King Saul na baka dumating yung panahon na hindi na siya ang maging hari, si David na ang maging hari. Insecurity. That is insecurity, my friend. One of the root causes of anger, why you are so angry today, believe it or not, aminin mo man to o hindi, ina-insecure ka. Yes or no? Pag dumating na si insecurity sa puso mo, sa buhay mo, sa isip mo, sa katauhan mo, I gonna tell you already, you will become an angry and a very angry person. That is what's happening in the world today. Because people today are very much insecure with what's happening in the world, many people today are angry. Pag sumakayan sa kotse niya, sa sakyan niya, haharurot yan, walang pakialam sa batas ng Pilipinas yan, walang pakialam sa batas ng trapiko yan, kasi galit siya. Bakit? Kasi nai-insecure siya. Mawawala na siya ng trabaho, mawawala na siya ng negosyo, papano na ang future ng mga anak niya, papano na ang future ng family niya, papano na ang future niya. Insecurities. Ladies and gentlemen, if we are not able to conquer our negative emotions, the negative emotion of envy, insecurity, we will always live in anger and you will become a very angry person. What happens? You get into big trouble. Are you still with me? My brothers and sisters in the Lord, envy, insecurity, are root causes of anger in the case of King Saul. And same thing with us, I believe with all my heart, if we harbor envy, pag naglagay tayo ng envy, ng inggit sa puso natin, pag naglagay tayo ng insecurity sa puso natin, sa buhay natin, we will become very angry persons. What do we see in the case of King Saul? He was very much angry at David. Not only because he was envious, insecure, but also he was afraid. Number three, root cause of David's or King Saul's anger is what? Fear. Takot. Natatakot siya. Natatakot siyang mawala sa posisyon. natatakot siya na baka mas magaling na sa kanya si David. That's why in verse number 6 of chapter number 18, we will see there. Let's go to 1 Samuel chapter 18, verse number 6. You know, from that moment in time, si David o si King Saul, so look at David with suspicion. That's the point. So look at David with suspicion from that day on. Meaning to say, can you see the fear of King Saul? Yes. King Saul was so afraid of David. Every time he would see David, he was so suspicious on David. Why? Because he was so afraid. And because he was so afraid, he is always angry at David. He's always angry at David. Tatlong bagay po makikita po natin ngayon pong umagang ito on how, what are the negative effects and the long-term negative effects of anger in our lives. So are you ready to learn? Are you ready to roll? Let's go. There are three things that we're gonna see in this study. Number one, anger displeases God. That is one of the negative effects of anger in our lives. Anger displeases God. Number two, anger destroys relationships. That is dangerous, my friend. Number three, anger delays God's blessings. That is even more dangerous, my friends. Anger delays God's blessings. Are you ready for number one? Let's go to number one. Anger displeases God. Let's go to 1 Samuel chapter number 18. Now it came about on the next day that an evil spirit from God came mightily upon Saul, and he raved in the midst of the house while David was playing the harp with his hand as usual, and a spear was in Saul's hand. What do you mean when the Bible says an evil spirit from God came mightily upon Saul? Very simple. That does not mean, ladies and gentlemen, that God has an evil spirit. No, that hindi po yan ang ibig sabihin po niyan. Ang ibig sabihin niyan, a very simple explanation to that is that God himself was not pleased with King Saul anymore. Actually, if you would look at 1 Samuel chapter 16, the anointing of God departed from King Saul. That is very sad. That is actually a very sad. That is the saddest part of King Saul's career as the very first king of Israel. The anointing of God departed from King Saul. Meaning to say, God was no longer pleased with King Saul. Amen? Why? Because King Saul was, he became a very angry person. You know, during Bible times, during the Old Testament, should I say, during the Old Testament, the Holy Spirit only abides, nananatili lamang ang banal na Espiritu sa puso ng people of God kapag ka ang puso po ng tao, siya ay malinis. Kapag ka siya po ay sumusunod po sa Diyos, kapag ka siya po ay nilulugod niya ang Diyos, pero kapag ka po, listen to this, kapag ka po ang isang anak ng Diyos, the people of Israel, people of God, hindi po sila sumusunod sa Diyos. Individually po ito, ha? Individually po yan, and even nationally, umaalis po yung presensya po ng Diyos. Meaning to say, the Holy Spirit, wala po silang indwelling ministry during the Old Testament. Only in the New Testament that the Holy Spirit indwelt the believer, and the Holy Spirit will live forever and ever and ever. But not so in the Old Testament. In the Old Testament, once you displeased God, the Holy Spirit will depart from you. And ladies and gentlemen, your life will be in big, big trouble. That is why King Saul, no wonder, it's no surprise, he was so angry. You know why? Because the anointing of the Holy Spirit was no longer upon King Saul during that time. What is our point? Our point is this. Anger displeases God. Now, don't get me wrong. Pastor, are all angers displease God? No, not all anger displeases the Lord. There are righteous anger. There are righteous anger, just like Jesus. When he got angry at the temple, that is righteous anger. You know, he is angry at sin. That is what we call righteous anger. Jesus was righteously angry at those people. Well, of course, though Jesus was righteously angry, Jesus never hurt anyone. He never hurt people. He never hurt people physically. He just expressed his righteous anger. In a deeper term, righteous indignation. Isang galit na banal. So, not all anger are unrighteous. There are righteous anger. Not all anger are technically sinful. Hindi naman po lahat ng galit ay technically sinful. For example, I'm a father, nagalit ako sa aking anak dahil gumagawa siya ng hindi maganda. That is righteous anger. I mean, that is not sinful in nature. For example, my wife, Elsa, yeah, she gets angry at me because, you know, I become infidel. Oh, that is righteous anger. That is not sinful. That is not technically sinful. Do we understand what we are talking about right now? Hindi po lahat ng galit ay kasalanan. But in the case of King Saul, because his anger, the very root cause of King Saul's anger is envy, insecurity, fear. Ladies and gentlemen, that displeases the Lord. Amen? So if you're angry, or if your anger roots out from insecurity, from fear, from envy, ladies and gentlemen, that displeases the Lord. Anger is a very serious problem of men. Anger, especially believers, is a very serious problem. If you're a believer of Jesus Christ and you live an angry life, that displeases the Lord. You're a child of God. You're supposed to live in gentleness, kindness, not a perfect life, my friend. I'm not saying we got to be perfect for us not to be angry. No. We just have to obey God in everything that we do. Let's make it assured that we please God. Because anger displeases God in its very, very nature. Let's go to the New Testament. What does the New Testament say about anger? Let's go to the book of Ephesians. You know what? Listen to this very carefully. In the book of Ephesians, the Bible tells us that if we get angry, let us not sin. Do we have a verse to that in the book of Ephesians? Ephesians chapter 4, verses 26 to 27. Let's read all together. Be angry. Can you imagine that? The Apostle Paul is commanding the Ephesian church to be angry. But you do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your anger. You see? Anger is not always sinful. If you get angry, make it assured you do not sin. And number two, do not let the sun go down on your anger. And verse 27, the Bible says, and do not give the devil. That is the point of the Apostle Paul. Do not give the devil an opportunity. Can you imagine? Meaning, anger can give the devil an opportunity. What? To put you into big trouble, my friend. So be careful with your anger. If you get angry, the Bible says, you make it assured you do not sin. Make it assured that your anger is a righteous anger. Another point is this, do not let the sun go down on your anger. Meaning to say, that is not literal, of course. Well, of course, hindi naman talaga madaling humupa ang galit natin eh. Yes or no? Meaning to say, huwag mo nang pagtagalin, huwag mo nang, kung kaya mo nang humingi ng apology, kung kailangan mo humingi ng tawad sa asawa mo, humingi ka na ng tawad sa asawa mo, ano pang ginagawa mo? Yung pong ibig sabihin, do not let the sun go down. Hindi naman literal yan na, I mean, right there and then, no? Kung nag-away po kayo ng medyo alas 5 ng hapon, pababa na po, eh, alimbawa, 5:59, no, nagalit ka, eh, siyempre, hindi naman po talaga basta yung galit, humuhu pa. Ang ibig sabihin po ng Bible, huwag mong pagtagalin ang galit mo. Dahil pag pinagtagal mo ang galit mo, according to verse number 37, you are giving the devil an opportunity to get you into big trouble. Your marriage will be in big trouble. Your family life will be in big trouble. Are you with me? Your business might be in big trouble if you harbor anger in your heart for the longest time. Prolonged anger. Are you with me? According to studies, prolonged anger is very, very unhealthy. It's gonna kill you. I repeat, prolonged anger is unhealthy, very unhealthy. Ang galit na pinagtatagal is very unhealthy for you. And so when the Bible says, when God says, do not be angry, and if you will get angry, do not sin, ladies and gentlemen, it is always for your good. It is always for your own sake. God is protecting you when He commands you, do not be so angry. Conquer your anger. Why? It is for your benefit. Prolonged anger can what? Can increase your what? Your blood pressure. Yes or no? Pwede kang magkasakit sa puso. Pag nagkasakit ka sa puso, konting galit. Well, I have heard many stories na nagalit at yung isang napakatinding galit na yon ang pumatay sa kanya. Anger is very unhealthy. Are you with me so far? Ikaw ba'y galit ngayon? If you harbor hunger for the longest time, number one, it displeases the Lord. And if you displease God, you will not be blessed by God. You will miss God's blessings. You will miss many blessings from God. If you live in anger, mga kaibigan, tatagalogin ko po, English pa rin, ang hirap talaga magdiretso ng Tagalog, ano? Anyway, naintindihan nyo naman po, ibig sabihin, kapag ka po tayo po ay namuhay sa galit, marami kang mga pagpapala ng Diyos na mamimiss eh. Gusto mo ba yan? Gusto mo bang pagpalain ng Diyos? Yes or no? Ay, ako gusto kong pagpalain ng Diyos. Better yet, God is telling you and me, refrain from being angry every day because you will miss a lot from God. I repeat, you will miss a lot from God if you live in anger. Amen? You will miss the gift of forgiveness. You will miss the gift of love. Yan ang nagpapapayapa ng buhay natin. You will miss the gift of peace. You know, when people are always angry, may kapayapaan ba yan? May pag-ibig ba sa puso yan? Kind ba yan? Gentle ba yan? Of course not. You will miss the fruits of the Holy Spirit if you are angry every day. You know why? Because anger is the exact opposite of the fruits of the Holy Spirit. Love, joy, peace, gentleness, kindness, goodness, and all those. What's our topic today? Sabihin mo sa katabi mo, conquer your anger because anger displeases God. What do you see with King Saul? Nakakawa naman si King Saul. Nanalo na sa digmaan. It was a victorious day for them. But King Saul was very angry at David. What happened? The Spirit of God departed from King Saul himself. And so, it becomes worse actually. It becomes worse. Number two, not only anger displeases God. Number two, anger destroys relationships. Yes or no? Ilang relasyon na ang sinira po ng galit? Yung matagal na galit, dami na po. No? Ang dami na pong sinirang relasyon ng galit. Ang dami na pong sinirang tahanan ng galit. Ang dami na pong sinirang negosyo ng galit. Ang dami na pong, listen to this, ang dami na pong sinirang simbahan ng galit. Ang dami na pong sinirang partnership ng galit. Mga kaibigan, that's how dangerous anger is. Nagwawasak yan ang buhay ng tao. And that's what we wanna see today. What happened when King Saul got very angry at David because he was envious, because he was afraid, because he was so insecure at David? What happens? Just look at 1 Samuel chapter number 17. You know what? Anger is a very dangerous thing. Saul hurled the spear, for he thought, I will pin David to the wall. But David escaped from his presence twice. Now Saul was afraid of David, for the Lord was with him, but had departed from King Saul. What do you see with that, ladies and gentlemen? It destroys relationship. Yung imbis na, imbis na magka-partner sila, dahil nakita niya yung potential nitong bata na ito, but this is a warrior. 5 smooth stones ang dala-dala. Tapos isang tungkod ng isang pastol ang dala-dala, napatay yung giant. Dapat mag-celebrate siya eh. Dapat nga natutuwa siya dahil yung kanyang protege, yung kanyang pong mentee, tawagin na po natin, sabihin natin sa panahon natin, yung kanyang pong disciple, may potential to. This is an asset to our kingdom. Instead of Saul rejoicing and celebrating for David's victory, he got angry. Well, in fact, he planned to kill David. He planned to kill David according to the verse. Alright? There are things that we're gonna see. What's our next point? Our next point is this. Anger destroys relationships. Number one, it destroys what? Number one relationship is partnership and friendship. Yan ang dinidestroy niyan. Let's look at that point. That it destroys friendship and partnership. Dapat magkaibigan na si King Saul tsaka si David. Hindi ba? Pero dahil po dun sa sobrang galit po niya kay David, what happens? Yung pong gift of friendship and partnership na dapat partner po sila dahil pareho naman silang magaling, at dahil po dun sa insecurity, envy, at takot ni King Saul na nauwi po sa sobrang galit, imbis na mauwi po sa friendship at partnership, na-destroy po yung kanilang pagkakaibigan at ang kanilang relationships. Tignan po natin at i-apply po natin sa ating personal na buhay yung ating pong pinag-uusapan ngayon. Okay? Tignan po natin yung verse na yun. Kung paano nasira yung kanila pong relationship. Nakita po natin doon, therefore Saul removed him. Oh, wow! Removed him from his presence and appointed him as his commander of 1,000. Well, not actually, listen to this, that move of King Saul of promoting David was not actually to promote David per se. No. But actually to plot a wicked plan kay David. Kaya niya ginawang commander para, dahil siya ang commander, siya ang nasa harapan ng digmaan, mas madali siyang mamamatay. That move of King Saul was to really kill David. He appointed David as the new commander of 1,000. And what happened there? And he went out and came in before the people. But you know what? Because God was with David, in verse number 14, David was prospering in all his ways, for the Lord was with David. Oh, wow. And in verse number 15, let's go back to that. Verse number 15. When Saul saw that he was prospering greatly, he dreaded him. What do you see with King Saul? Nagahalo yung takot, nagahalo yung galit, na gusto niyang patayin si David. What is our point? Ladies and gentlemen, our point is this. Anger, if you are not careful with anger, it's gonna destroy relationships, especially friendships, especially partnerships. We are partners. Lalo pa ngayong panahon po ng pandemya, itong panahon po ng krisis, partner po tayo. No, huwag nating hayaan yung mga galit natin, yung mga naipon nating galit dahil na insecure lang tayo, dahil na nainggit lang tayo, dahil natakot lang tayo, baka mas mapalitan tayo sa posisyon, maagaw yung posisyon sa atin. Huwag po natin, let us not give the devil an opportunity. Are you with me? To take advantage of us. The enemy is taking advantage of us. The enemy is expert in destroying relationships, especially friendships and partnerships. Why? Because if we are partners in the kingdom of God, mga kaibigan ko, mga magkakapatid sa mananampalataya, na mananampalataya, hindi lamang po sa Acts 2 Community Church, kundi sa mga churches na nanonood po sa atin ngayon, especially leaders, could we be very careful in the negative emotion of anger? Because that would be used by the enemy to take advantage of us so that the kingdom will not prosper, so that the kingdom will not, what? Will not enlarge. That is the weapon, the very best weapon of our enemy is the negative emotion of anger. I have told you a while ago that anger is a much taller giant than Goliath. If you don't decide today to conquer your anger, sooner or later, that giant of anger will destroy partnerships, will destroy friendships, just like what King Saul was doing to David. Imbis na sila'y pumasok sa isang maigting and intimate relationship of friendship and partnership, he was so envious, insecure, got angry at David. Number two, anger can also destroy family relationships. Not only friendships and partnerships, but family relationships. Could we look at that point? Family relationships. In 1 Samuel chapter number 18, as a reward for David of killing the giant named Goliath. Can you still remember? The reward is mapapangasawa niya ang isang member ng royal family. Alright? But, you know, that reward, ginamit ito ni King David, o ni King Saul, should I say, para dayain pa, i-deceive pa si David. Dahil galit siya kay David. So, ginamit niya itong reward na ito just for David to be deceived. And if King Saul deceives David, he has now the opportunity to kill David. Let's go. Verse 17. Then Saul said to David, "Here is my older daughter, Merab. I will give her to you as a wife. Only be a valiant man for me and fight the Lord's battles." Sounds good. That might sound good, but it's not so good. "For Saul thought, my hand shall not be against him, but let the hand of the Philistines be against him." Alright? Number one, as a reward, King Saul will give David his older daughter, Merab. Number two, he will be promoted. Well, of course, he was promoted as the commander. But verse 18 said, "But David said to Saul, who am I? What is my life or my father's family in Israel that I should be the king's son-in-law?" Verse number 19. No more? I think, yan, verse number 19. "So it came about at the time when Merab, Saul's daughter, should have been given to David, that she was given to Adriel, the Meholathite, for a wife. Now Michal, Saul's daughter, loved David when they told Saul the king was agreeable to him." You know, what do you see in that passage of scripture? You know, David was deceived by King Saul instead of Merab na magiging asawa ni David. Ladies and gentlemen, ang ibinigay niya si Michal. Why? Just to deceive David. What do you see? The family is already involved. The family is already involved here. The family is being destroyed simply because of that negative emotion of anger. Nasisira ang pamilya. Nasisira yung family relationships. Hey, alam ko po, bawat pamilya po nanonood po sa atin po ngayon at nakikinig. May I encourage everyone, family members, fathers, parents, let us be very, very careful with the negative emotion of anger. I am speaking to myself. I am speaking to my very family members. We are all guilty with this. At times, we get angry for no valid reasons. We are not aware that we are envious. We are not aware that we are insecure. We are not aware that we are fearful and anxious. That's why we get angry. What happens? We destroy family relationships. Tatay, galit ka ba sa anak mo ngayon? May I suggest you forgive. Nanay, galit ka ba sa asawa mo ngayon? May I suggest you forgive. Boss, galit ka ba sa employee mo ngayon? May I suggest you forgive. Employee, galit ka ba sa boss mo ngayon? May I suggest you forgive. Now, but let's go to family. Let's go to family relationships. Many family lives are being destroyed by anger. You know, I've been hearing this story many times. Every time I counsel family members, you know, the problem, material things. They fight over material things. They fight over a 100 square meter lot. Come on, guys. I mean, it's not worth it, eh. Hindi ba? Let us not trade family relationships with that piece of land, 100 square meter. Come on. We are people of God. We are heirs of heaven. You know, let us value what God values. Pahalagahan natin kung anong pinapahalaga ng Diyos. Family is very valuable to God. Do you realize, before church was instituted by Jesus Christ, at the Garden of Eden, He first instituted family. Meaning to say, family is very valuable to God. Huwag nating ipagpalit ang relasyong pampamilya sa mga bagay na nahawakan, sa mga bagay na nakikita, kahit pa sa posisyon. Just like King Saul, can you imagine that? Dahil takot na takot siya mawala sa posisyon, what happens? Ginugulo niya ang sarili niyang pamilya. Pinag-aaway niya ang sarili niyang pamilya. Mga kaibigan, again, I wanna say this and I wanna repeat this, it's not worth it. It's not worth it. Let us value family relationships. At the end of the day, mga kaibigan, bago tayo umalis dito sa mundong ito, ha? Pagka nandun ka na sa sickbed mo o sa deathbed mo, mga kaibigan, ang hahanapin mo, family members mo eh. Ano magagawa niyang kakarampot na pirasong lupa na yan na pinag-aagawan nyo ngayon? May I suggest, pray to the Lord, surrender that wrong desires to the Lord. Ha? Surrender that wrong desires to the Lord. You give it up and tawagan mo na. Tawagan mo na yung kapamilya mo ngayon na galit ka kasi ang pakiramdam mo, dinadaya ka. Ang pakiramdam mo, iniisahan ka, nilalamangan ka. Tawagan mo, sabi mo sa kanyang, patawarin mo ko, pinapatawad na rin kita. Let us reconcile. Amen? Why? Anger destroys family relationship. At sabihin ko sa iyo, huwag mo nang pagtagalin yan. Pag pinagtagal mo pa yung galit na yan, lalalim ng lalalim yan. Parang iceberg po yan, lalalim ng lalalim yan. At hindi mo na kayang buwagin yan. Sooner or later, ikaw ang lalamunin ng galit mo at ikaw ang papatayin ng galit mo. I mean, wala tayong panalo sa galit. Anger will always win if we don't learn the skill of conquering our own anger. Amen? What's our topic today? Conquer your own anger. Because anger destroys relationships. Anger displeases God. I'm reminded of this guy by the name of Alexander the Great. Alexander the Great was a great conqueror. Well, according to history, almost half of the world, Alexander the Great, you know, he conquered it. He had a friend by the name of Cleitus. Alexander the Great and Cleitus, they were very best friends. I mean, well, in fact, si Cleitus, katulad po ni King Saul, ginawa po niyang commander, military commander po niya yan, Macedonian military commander. You know what? Once upon a time, sa isang inuman, nagiinuman po sila, you know, kakasiyahan po sila, no? Ang akala nitong si Alexander the Great, pinagtatawanan siya nitong kanyang kaibigan si Cleitus. Pinagtatawanan siya para akala niya kinukutsa-kutsa siya kasi may mga kasama din siya doon sa inuman na yon. Nung makita ni Alexander the Great na akala niya pinagtatawanan siya ni Cleitus at kinukutsa-kutsa siya, ano mo ginawa ni Alexander the Great? Kinuha po niya yung kanya pong knife. At kutulod po na ginawa ni King Saul kay David, kanya pong pinin si Cleitus hanggang si Cleitus po ay namatay. A very sad story of best friends just because of anger. Nasira po, hindi lamang po ang kanila pong friendship as best friends, pero sumira po ng buhay yung galit po ni Alexander the Great. That's how dangerous anger is. That's how dangerous unconquered and uncontrolled anger is. Pag hindi po natin na-control at hindi po natin na-conquer, nagapi ang ating pong giant of anger, it's gonna destroy many, many lives and relationships. What is number two? Anger destroys relationships. Last but not the least. Are you still with me? I hope you are still with me watching. Stay put and we will close with this. Number three, anger delays God's blessings. I do not want that to happen in my life, my friend. I mean, I always pray for God's blessings. Every day, almost every night, almost every day when I wake up in the morning, all I say is this, God bless me, God bless my family, and God, may you bless my family. Excuse me, my family indeed. I mean, I am so serious in praying to the Lord that God will bless my family. I am so serious in praying to the Lord that God would bless my ministry. But, you know what? What delays God's blessings to us? Could it be that you have a harbored anger in your heart today? Could it be that you have a prolonged anger? You don't forgive people? Believe it or not, unforgiveness delays God's blessings. Believe it or not, prolonged anger delays God's blessings. In the case of King Saul, victory after victory, mga kaibigan. You know what? After David killed Goliath, he invaded. Oh, he won another battle actually. David won another battle. But because of King Saul's anger, another victory was being delayed by God. You know why? Because King Saul was harboring an uncontrolled anger in his very heart. Let's see the scripture. How victorious David was against their enemies, the enemies of the people of Israel. Verse number 8 of chapter number 19, when there was war again. You know, this is another scenario. There was war again. David went out and fought with the Philistines and defeated them with great slaughter so that they fled before him. What do you see? That's another victory. David was being blessed by God because God's hands was upon David. God's presence was upon David. Every time David will go and fight, he's always victorious. Verse number 9. Now there was an evil spirit again from the Lord on Saul as he was sitting in his house with his spear in his hand, and David was playing the harp with his hand. Verse number 10, Saul tried to pin David. He tried to kill David again to the wall with the spear, but he slipped away out of Saul's presence. So he stuck the spear into the wall, and David fled and escaped that night. You know, David, he always manages to escape, right? Because the presence of God was with David. Verse 11, then Saul sent messengers to David's house to watch him. Can you imagine? He sent a spy just to watch for David, just to watch David, in order to what? To put him to death in the morning. Can you feel the anger? The level of anger of King Saul to David? Unstoppable eh. Hindi ba? Hindi maawat na galit. To the point of killing, plotting to kill David many times. But Michal, David's wife, told him, saying, if you do not save your life tonight, tomorrow you will be put to death. What do you see in that passage? The blessing of God was delayed. Instead of victory after victory for the people of Israel, for the kingdom, for the benefit and for the credit of King Saul, what happened? The very anger of King Saul boomeranged to the detriment not only of his life, if you will see the life of King Saul, because of his anger, my friend. King Saul got depressed. And because he got depressed, King Saul, he killed himself. He committed suicide. Ladies and gentlemen, where is the blessing to that? Ang pagpapala ng Diyos ay nade-delay kapag tayo po ay nag-harbor ng resentment, nag-harbor po tayo, nagtatanim po tayo ng galit, iniipon po natin yung galit po natin sa ating puso for the longest time. May I suggest again, you forgive people, sabihin mo nga sa katabi mo, forgive. Amen? Let us forgive people. That is for your own sake. That is for your own sake, my friend. That is for your good. If you forgive and forgive people, that actually is for your sake. Para sa kabutihan mo yan. Para sa kabutihan ng pamilya mo yan. Para sa kabutihan ng negosyo mo yan. Para sa kabutihan ng future mo yan. So that you will be blessed by God. I do not want God to delay and delay His blessings to me. Well, I have to confess to you that once upon a time, I was so angry. Yes, I was so angry. And you know what? The more I live in anger, the more I hurt myself. The more I live in anger almost every day, pag matutulog ako, galit ako. Galit ako sa kapwa ko. Galit ako sa mga nanakit sa akin. Galit ako sa mga nandaya sa akin. Galit ako sa mga tao na nag-criticize sa akin, you know? Galit ako sa mga tao na you know, I don't deserve. I feel like I don't deserve their judgments. Galit ako doon sa mga tao, you know, they have wrong judgments to me. Now what happens to me? I was hurting myself, and because I was hurting myself, I could no longer bear that anger in my heart. I got depressed. And that depression in my heart, you know what? Pinahirapan ako niyan physically, emotionally, psychologically. You know what? The Lord told me, Erick, better yet, before it gets worse and worse, you forgive people. I praise God. You know, I praise the Lord. I praise God for His goodness in my life. I thank God for the Holy Spirit. I thank the Holy Spirit. He speaks to me every day. Erick, you got to conquer your anger, forgive people. When I learned to do that, my friend, when I learned to do that, I can almost hear the very voice of the Holy Spirit in my life, moment by moment. Now, I can live a peaceful life. those people who've hurt me in the past, they can no longer hurt me in the present. You know why? Because I have learned to forgive them. And now, we can say, God is good. You know what? This is the catch. This is the catch of this story. This is the catch of this story. When I learned to forgive and conquer my anger in my heart, you know what? I can no longer count God's blessing in my life. Well, of course, not always material, not always financial, but you know, those unseen, you know, blessings, those intangible blessings that I receive from God, I can no longer count, my friend. You know why? Because God taught me big time, to forgive and love and learn to live a life of love, a life of peace, and a life of joy, free from uncontrolled anger. Well, I'm not saying I become perfect. I'm still a work in progress in the area of anger. At times, it keeps coming back in my mind. At times, it keeps coming back in my heart. But I thank the Lord because He loves me. He always reminds me, oh, Erick, forgive, love, be joyful. I want to bless your life. My friend, do you want God to bless your life? Do you want God to bless your life? May I suggest, magpatawad ka, tanggalin mo ang galit mo sa puso mo. Do you want your family to be blessed by God? Yes or no? I know every one of us, we want God to bless our families. Yes, we want God to bless our families. So may I suggest, and the Lord is telling us, let us learn to forgive and not harbor anger. And let us conquer that giant of anger in our lives. If that giant of anger is already defeated, my friend, I can tell you, you will live a peaceful life. Amen? You will live a peaceful life, and as a result, that is God's blessings to you. If you conquer your anger, you are saying to yourself, I want to welcome God's blessings in my life. I want God to bless me. I do not want those people who've hurt me in the past will hurt me time and time again. Pag pinanatili mo ang galit mo at hindi ka nagpatawad sa mga tao na nanakit sa'yo in the past, hinahayaan mo silang saktan ka nila kahit sa oras na natutulog ka na at namamahinga ka na. Better yet, you surrender that anger to the Lord, conquer your anger so that you could live a blessed life. With that, may God bless us all, and my prayer to all of us is that we will not be like King Saul, who lives in anger to the point that his very life and his kingdom was in danger. With that, may I ask you to just bow your head, close your eyes, let us pray. Our dear God, we want to thank you, Lord, for this wonderful message, Lord, that you have given us. Thank you, Father, for being so gracious to us, being so merciful to us, hearing this message. Because, yes, all of us are struggling in the area of the negative emotion of anger. Thank you, Father, for reminding us that anger is very unhealthy, very, very dangerous. It destroys lives. It destroys relationships, friendships. And most especially, Father, anger displeases you and it delays your blessings. Father, we want to be blessed by you. And Lord, what hinders us for that blessing is that negative emotion of anger. Father, today, we ask you to give us your grace and mercy so that we will learn to forgive and learn to live a peaceful life by surrendering to you our anger. Sinusuko po namin sa inyo ngayon pong umaga ang mga galit na nasa puso po namin ngayon. Panginoon, alam ko po at alam niyo po na ang bawat tahanan po ngayon, ang bawat pamilya ay may mga conflicts, may mga galit na nananatili sa kanilang mga puso. Ang bawat nanay, galit sa kanilang mga anak, ang mga anak, galit sa kanilang mga magulang. Panginoon, dinadalangin ko po, Panginoon, tanggalin niyo po ang espiritu ng galit sa kanila pong mga pamilya. Dinadalangin ko, Ama, bigyan niyo po ng espiritu ng pagkakasundo, espiritu ng pagpapatawad. Dinadalangin ko po ang inyong mga simbahan, ang mga churches. Panginoon, ngayon po, kami po ay nagagapi ng pagkakaiba-iba namin bilang mga tunay na simbahan nyo. At Satan is really taking advantage of us. Sinisira po ng amin pong kaaway na si Satanas ang relasyon ng bawat mananampalataya sa bawat iglesia. Panginoong Diyos, tinadalangin ko po, papasukin niyo po ang espiritu ng pagpapatawad, pag-ibig sa bawat iglesia po ngayon. Sa kabila po ng amin pong mga pagkakaiba-iba, turuan niyo kaming magpatawad, magmahalan sa isa't isa upang ang inyong pong simbahan ay tunay po, Panginoon, to really take advantage of our enemy and not the other way around, O Lord. O God, thank you so much for this wonderful message that you have given us. Thank you for your words, for the power of your words. Help us to apply your words so that our lives will be transformed. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for loving us. And Lord, we say, we love you. We love you so much, Lord. This we pray in the name of your one and only true Son, Jesus Christ, and all the people said, Amen and Amen. Maraming salamat po sa inyo pong pagsamba. Nakasama po kami sa inyo pong panonood. Dalangin po namin kayo po'y mag-ingat sa lahat po ng pagkakataon. Ang pagpapala po ng Diyos, ang biyaya ng Diyos, ang awa ng Diyos ay pumasa ating lahat. God bless us. Keep safe, everyone. See you next Sunday.